Hello, so this is the third lecture on basic concept of Java, and yesterday we have discussed about type of variables, instance variable, local variable, methods and object creation and how to call a method. So today we'll discuss, we'll go deeper into the method concepts and we'll discuss why methods are important and important interview questions related to the methods topic. So let's start. So this is the method that we have declared yesterday. This is the syntax. What are the information we have to give to the method when we declare the method is visibility condition, return type, method name, and the body of the method. So here the return type is given as void for this method called add. So as we are not returning anything, we can keep it as a void. So if you are planning to return a string from add method, we are expecting that we can get a integer value from this method operation. So we have to give a return type as integer, and same applies for a string value. So if we are planning to return a string from this function, so as a result of this method calling, we are expecting some string value should be written, so we have to give a return type as string. Otherwise, if nothing is written, then we can keep it as a void. So let's change the return type from void to integer and we'll see how it behaves. So we have changed the integer return type to integer. Now it's giving me an error message like this method must return a result of type integer. So when the moment I declare the return type, I mention the return type as integer, is asking me to give a return statement. So I will click here. I'll select add a return statement. So I have given a integer type, return type as integer, and I'm expecting I'll get a value return, and whatever the operation that is performed is summation of these three variables, the instance variable and the local variable, that will be written to us when this method is called. So I'll remove this print statement as of now. So this is the method. Similarly, we can also change it to a string, and if we are expecting some string text value in the return statement. So as we are dealing with the integer variables, these all are integers, so we have mentioned as the integer return type and return as we have mentioned as a sum. So this is the addition operation we are performing on this variables. So we'll call this method and we'll see. So it ran successfully. I'll save this in a variable as we're expecting some integer value. Integer val equals to, and I'll print to see whether we are getting a correct written value or not. So and I'll print this value. See, 35 20 plus 10 35 35. So correct result is getting displayed. So this is the one way we can call a method. We have mentioned a return type and we have written a value, and we have called this method and value is printed. So but here we are hard coding this value, we are passing this value, we are expecting this function should take the value that is assigned to A, B and C in the class, and it will sum up that value. So what we can do as in a better way, we can pass this an argument So whenever we'll call this method from main method, we'll assign a argument, we'll assign a value in the argument, and it will print, it will perform this function accordingly. So what I'm saying is that I'll remove this hard coding value. I'll mention that so what I'm saying that I need a method which will perform an addition action on this three integer value, and as a return it will return the addition of this three integer. So when now it's giving me an error message. See error message what saying that in a method add we have to give a three integer argument that is not present here. So we have called a math, we have created an object, and we have written obj.add, and here when we'll call this method we have to pass this argument at the time of calling this method. So here we are calling an argument. I'll write here 10, 5, 20. As we know, this is the object. We have created object because we directly cannot access the class variable and method. So we have to create a object for that. We created a object. How we can create an object? We have discussed yesterday that we'll write a class name, then object name using a new keyword and followed by the class name. Now this obj is the object we have created. So we'll use a obj and we give a dot, then we'll get all the option of the class variable and the method that belongs to that class. So I selected the add method. In add method, what variable I have, argument I have to pass? Three integer value. So I have passed three integer value, and now I'll run this program and see how it is behaving. So it is printing the value 25 because we have passed three variable. So the main important function is like important is this, we are reusing the functionality. We have written this method once and we can call this method multiple times with different integer value. So I'll store in a different variables and I'll pass a different, and I'll run the value, I'll print the value of the second. See, I'm getting the value. So the main advantage of this method is code reusability. We can write a method once and use it multiple times. We do not have to rewrite the entire code each time. So in the above like method, what we have created a method called add which performs the function of the addition of this three integer variable. So we can use the same method again and again to perform addition number with different integer value. So if you give any other data type, it will give an error message. If you want to perform with the same action with different data type, then we have to create a different method, same method with different data type, then we can perform the action. So we'll discuss that in the later point. So this is the how like beauty of this functionality method. So we can call it and we can use this functionality numbers of times with different argument. So what I was discussing was method overloading. Method overloading is a function like a class can have multiple numbers of method. So this is one method. Similarly, I can have another method as well. So So now I'm getting a error message. The error message is this is a duplicate method of add an integer variable. So it's not allowing me to write. So if I want to perform a similar adding function with different data type or different integer arguments type, so we can write a method. So I've removed the integer c from here. I've removed the integer from addition. So now the error messages are gone. So now we have created two methods under same class. First method is add. Second method name is also add, and both are the return type integer. But only difference is that the first method takes three argument as a argument, and in the second method it takes two argument. So this functionality is called method overloading. Method overloading means is a situation where we have a method with same name, but the parameter, but they have different signatures. Signatures, when I say signature, means they have different arguments. Arguments, there are three ways we can overload a method. So one, the number of parameters should be different, like here we have given 3 and here we have given 2. The second was data type should be different. The suppose in the first one I am adding integer, the second one I'll add a string, or I'll add a float or double, any in a different data type than first one. And the other one is sequence of data types should be different. Like in first one I'll integer and I'll give a float, and in second one I'll have a same name of the method, but I'll write float first then integer. So this is the third way of overloading a method. So we'll take an example and we'll see. The first one is this one. I'll call a method. We have created a method ABC passing as an integer, and second method with same name, and but we are passing two argument. So no need to change anything. What we are doing here, we already created an object of that class, object.add. We are calling that method. We can call that method dot add and then the bracket, and as a bracket is expecting a argument. So we have given 3 argument in the first one and the second one 2 argument. So how this is understanding that which method we are calling is based on the number of parameters we are passing. If we are passing 3 argument, it understands that it has to pop calling the first method, and in the second one we are passing 2 arguments, so it's understand that second method is called. So we'll run this Java program and see how this is behaving. So see, the first one we have got 25, 10, 10 plus 5, and the second one we have got 105. So this is the first way of method overloading, where we have given different number of parameters in the argument. So in different argument list, like we create a answer method. So we can create a number of method under a class. So I have created a different method. Here the method name is same, and argument I am passing is string a and b. Here we have string integer a and b, but both are performing the same operation. They are adding to argument that we are passing. Now we'll call this method. I'll change this is a user defined name. I have value 1, and it's not giving me an error message because we have a method called add with two integer types. So it's not giving. When we'll call, it will call a second method, this one. So I'll just change an argument and it will call the third method with a string type. So I'll give, we know a string we have to give in a double quote. I'll write so the value is string. I'll print the value of the third method as well, is value 1. So I'll run a program. See, first one with 3 argument, second one with 2 argument, third one with a different data type. So this is the second way where we can overload a method with difference in the data type of the parameters. So if two methods have same name, same parameters and have different return type, this is not a valid method overloading. So if we have suppose we have a method called see, it's giving me an error message. It's duplicate method thing, because it doesn't depend upon the type, return type of that method. We have to give parameters, the signature is differentiated by the number of arguments, by different data types. If we give the same data type and number of argument is also same, only the return type is different, then it's not a valid method overloading. So I'll remove this one. So what is the advantage of this one? So we don't method overloading, we don't have to create and remember different names for function, because we are performing the same function in every method. We are adding two numbers, but we want to add different values. Here we want to add different 3 integer value, 2 different values and 2 string values. So instead of creating a multiple method with different name and performing the same action, if we need to do a same kind of operation with different ways, with different input, so method overloading is important and we can use this function. Suppose if overloading was not supported by Java, so we have to create a different method names like add1, add2 and add3. So even though this are performing similar function, we have to give different name just to perform different action with different input types. So this all about method overloading. So one of the most important interview question is, can we overload a main method? So yesterday we have discussed that this is the main method and this is the entry point of any Java program. Without this main method, we cannot execute a Java program. So whenever we execute a Java program, it first search for a main method and it starts the program from there. So can we overload this method as well? So answer is yes, we can overload, but when we run a Java program, it always search for this signature, public static void main, and argument as string arguments. So how we can overload this method? We can create a So we have created a method named main and return type is void, which is similar to this, and visibility as public. And here we'll just print just print the this statement. This is overloaded main method. So as we are printing, we are not returning any integer, any string value. So we have given a void as a return type. So we'll call this main method. See, when we have object dot, I'm getting this main option. So main, as because this main method is also belongs to the same class. So I'll run the value, run the program. So it's printed. This is not overloaded main method. So that's all for today. In next lecture, we'll discuss about the static keyword. We have not discussed the static keyword and the class. We are creating a class and we are doing something. We are writing the program, but we have not discussed the class concept. So we'll discuss the class concept as well. So that's for all for today. Thank you.